Okay, so let's go ahead and try a different kind of force problem. The last one we did, if you look at the last video, was where an object is placed right on, let's say, a surface. So like a rooftop, I think I did in the last problem, and there's a very common one where there's a weight on a bench. Now we're going to do something where something's hanging. We have an object hanging. A good example of this, let's just say a weight, it doesn't really matter. Stop signs, old school stop signs, something like that. They have some object here that's hanging from a couple wires. Okay, let's do this. Let's say this wire is a little bit longer, and they're attached to something over here. I really don't care what it's attached to. What's important is all the forces that are acting upon this vector. And actually, I finally got the color working on my screen here, so I still think that maybe if I turn down my light here, okay, that will probably work out better for me. Okay, so let's see what happens. I have one vector like this, that's the weight of, let's say it's a stop sign, just to make life easy. And then this is pretty obvious what we have here. We have two other vectors. I'm going to call this one T sub 1, might as well. Common name for it. This is T sub 2. And we're going to look at these vectors. Of course, now if I were to tell you, okay, this is, system is in static equilibrium, I have to give you some other information. And the information I will give you is as follows. Let's suppose I know that this angle right here is 20 degrees. Sorry for the bad handwriting, but it's 20 degrees, I promise. And if I somehow give you this angle as well, and I'm going to tell you that that angle is, I have to do some math in my head, 70 degrees. All right. Then I know that altogether, if this is a horizontal right here, I know altogether this is going to be 180 degrees. 70 of it's taken on this side, 20 of it's taken on that side, so therefore this is a 90 degree angle. And right now in this course, we have to deal with things this way. It's not necessarily true that you always have to deal with that way. In fact, you might be able to get around this using other methods. But for now, I want to concentrate on that whole idea of a vector plus a vector plus a vector will sum up to zero. Okay, if this object in the center here is in equilibrium, static equilibrium, then I know that when I add T1 plus T2 plus W together, they should sum up to zero. So I want to somehow draw a picture. I'm going to steal vector T1. I'm going to place it over on this side of the board. I just figured out a little trick with my camera, so hopefully it'll work. Oops, that's not the same exact direction as T1. Let's try to get as accurate as possible. So here's T1. It's the vector. And then I want to take the other one that's 90 degrees to that and tack that on there. Now I know T2 is. So here's my 90 degree. And I'm going to draw it to have 90 degrees here. Because they are, this is T2. They are 90 degrees to one another. And then I know that the vector W will drop from that point, right? T1 plus T2 plus W. It's going to drop down from this point. I have a squeaky pen. Notice that it kind of, I drew my figure a little incorrectly. That's okay. I'll just erase right there a little bit. I know you, I think there's a little shine on the board up here, but anyway, this is the vector W. And again, just like the previous example, I already have a right triangle built up where the magnitude of W, oh, I didn't tell you that, let's pretend the magnitude of W is, for argument's sake, 20 pounds, 20 lbs. So I know that the magnitude over here is 20, the magnitude of W. And now it would be great to find either the angle between T2 and W or the angle between T1 and W. And what's nice here is that I have my choices. If you look over on this side of the board, I can grab W and throw it over here for all I care. In fact, that's completely fine. But what I really want to do, since T2 is going up this way and the arrow is pointing that way, and then W is attached attached to T2 over here, just like this. This would be an easy way to find that angle. Look, I just make a little right triangle here, and you see that this angle up here is going to be 70 degrees. Well, that's very nice. If that's 70 degrees, that's awesome. Because now I know my triangle. And this one, actually, I'm going to finish out, because I didn't do the last one. I didn't finish the last one out. I'm going to tilt this a little bit, so I have a triangle like the following, where this floor here, this leg on the floor, is the magnitude of T1. Oops. This leg right here is the magnitude of T2. And finally, this leg, or this hypotenuse, is the magnitude of W, which we know to be 20. This angle right here is 70 degrees. Whenever possible, just leave one angle in there. I know that it's tempting to fill this out as 20 degrees down here too, but that's just extra writing. Now, I know the cosine, and I might just do a little bit of erasing right now, but I know that the cosine of 70 degrees is going to equal the magnitude of T2 over the hypotenuse, the adjacent over hypotenuse. Therefore, the magnitude of T2 is equal to 20 times the cosine of 70 degrees. So you can plug that in your calculator if you really want to. This is an exact answer. An approximate answer would occur if we were to actually enter this into the calculator. Same idea, by the way, over here. You can find the magnitude of T1 the same way. This is somewhat of an intuitive way. I don't want to say it's an easy way. It's not. But it's somewhat of an intuitive way to do these problems. I hope that helps out. I'll try to do more of these later on.